In a survey of 25 students, it was found that 15 had taken mathematics, 12 had taken physics, and 11 had taken chemistry. 5 had taken mathematics and chemistry, 9 had taken mathematics and physics, and 4 had taken physics and chemistry, and 3 had taken all the 3 subjects. Find the number of students that had only chemistry, only mathematics, only physics, physics and chemistry but not mathematics, mathematics and physics but not chemistry, only one of the subjects, at least one of the 3 subjects, none of the subjects. Okay. So using Venn diagram, we are going to solve this problem. Okay. Here 3 sets are given, which are M, P and C. Okay, so M represent the set of students using mathematics, P be the physics, capital C be the chemistry. Okay, so first, given that 15 had taken mathematics. Okay, 15 had taken mathematics, so n of m equal to 15. Okay, so this is the mathematics circle. Okay, so in the mathematics circle we have A, B, D, E. Okay, so in the mathematics we have A, B, D, E. So 15 had taken mathematics, so we can write n of m equal to 15. So in the mathematics circle we have A, B, E, D. Okay, so summation of A plus B plus D plus E equal to 15. Okay, and given that 12 had taken physics. Okay, so we can write N of B, N of P equal to 12. Okay, so in the physics circle we have B, C, E, F. Okay, so we can write B plus, B plus, C plus, E plus, F equal to 12. Okay, B plus, B plus, C plus, E plus, F equal to 12. Okay, Levin had taken chemistry. So n of c, we can write n of c equal to 11. Okay, so in the chemistry circle we have D, E, F, G. Okay, so the sum of D plus E plus F plus G equal to 11. Okay, so given that 5 had taken mathematics and chemistry. Okay, so mathematics and chemistry, 5 had taken mathematics and chemistry. So mathematics and chemistry. Okay, so mathematics and chemistry. So this is the mathematics circle, this is the chemistry circle. So mathematics and chemistry, we have D and E. Okay, so D plus E equal to, D plus E equal to 5. Okay, so 5 had taken mathematics and chemistry, 5 had taken an mathematics and chemistry. Okay, so this area, this is the area for mathematics and chemistry. Okay, here we have D and E, so D plus E is 5. Okay, and 9 had taken mathematics and physics. Okay, 9 had taken mathematics and physics. For intersection, for AND, we use intersection. Okay, so the common area for mathematics and physics covers, so mathematics and physics, so this is the common area for mathematics and physics. Okay, so this is the common area for mathematics and physics. So B plus E. Okay, so 9 had taken mathematics and physics, so b plus e equal to 9. Okay, and 4 had taken physics and chemistry. So in the Venn diagram, for physics and chemistry we have this area. Okay, so physics and chemistry we have E and F. So E plus F, physics and chemistry we have E plus F. Okay, so 4 had taken physics and chemistry, so we can write E plus F equal to 4. Okay, 3 had taken all the 3 subjects. Okay, 3 had taken all the 3 subjects, so the area covering all the 3 subjects in the Venn diagram is here. Okay, so this is the common area covering both Max, Physics, Chemistry. Okay, which is equal to E. Okay, so now we have E equal to 3 had taken all the 3 subjects, so we can write N of M intersection P intersection C equal to 3. So E is equal to 3. Okay, since E covers the area, E covers the common area. Okay, so E is 3. Okay, so E equal to 3. So in the so E equal to 3. So now start from here. Okay, D plus E equal to 5. So D plus E equal to 5. So writing D plus E equal to 5. So D plus, put the value of E equal to 3 here. Okay, so D plus 3 equal to 5. So D equal to, now D equal to 5 minus 3. Okay, so this 3 goes to this side. This becomes negative. So D is equal to 5 minus 3. So D is equal to 2. Okay, now we write B plus E equal to 9. Okay, so B plus E equal to 9, put E equal to 3. So B plus 3 equal to 9. So B is equal to 9 minus 3. So B equal to 6. Okay, now write E plus F equal to 4. Okay, so E plus F equal to 4, put E equal to 3. So put E equal to 3. So 3 plus F equal to 4. So F equal to 4 minus 3. So F equal to 1. Okay, so now 15, now write this equation. Okay, so A plus B plus D plus E equal to 15. A plus B plus D plus E equal to 15. So plug in the value of B here. A only unknown. Okay, so we are going to find A by plugging the value B, D, E. Okay, the value of B is 6, D is 2, E is 3, is equal to 15. So A plus 6 plus 2 plus 3 is 11, is equal to 15. So A equal to 15 minus 11. Okay, so therefore A equal to 15 minus 11 is 4. Okay, so now write the second equation. Okay, B plus, write this equation. So write this equation becomes B plus C plus E plus F equal to 12. Okay, so here except C, the remaining values are known. Okay, so B, E, F are known. So the value of B is 6 plus C plus value of E is 3 plus F. Yeah, the value of F is 1 is equal to 12. So C plus 6 plus 3 is 9. 9 plus 1 is 10. Okay, so C plus 10 equal to 12. So C equal to 12 minus 10. So C equal to 2. Okay, so C is equal to 2. Now write the third equation. So the third equation 11 had taken chemistry. Okay, so write the third equation. D plus, the third equation is D plus E plus F plus G is equal to 11. Okay, here G value is unknown. Okay, the remaining values are known. So plug in the value. D is 2, E is 3, F is 1. Okay, so 2 plus 3 plus 1 plus G is equal to 11. So 6 plus G is equal to 11. So G is equal to 11 minus 6. So G is equal to 5. Okay, now we have to find only number of students studying only chemistry. Okay, so only chemistry, for only chemistry we have G. Okay, so only chemistry G, only chemistry. Okay, for only chemistry we should not include this area. Okay, because it covers M and C, common area for M and C. Okay, so for only chemistry G. Okay, only physics C, only mathematics A. Okay, so here first we have to find only chemistry. So only chemistry is equal to G. Okay, so the value of G is 5. Okay, so 5 students. For only mathematics A, okay, only mathematics equal to A. For only mathematics A, only mathematics A, only physics C, only chemistry G. Okay, so now only chemistry equal to G, so 5 students. Only mathematics equal to A, so A, the value of A we have calculated, whose value is 4. Okay, so A is equal to 4 students. The value of only physics is C. Okay, so C corresponds to only physics. Okay, so that is equal to 2 students. Okay, physics and chemistry but not mathematics. Okay, so physics and chemistry but not mathematics, so which is equal to F. Physics and chemistry but not mathematics, so whose value is F. Okay, so physics and chemistry but not mathematics equal to F, so that is equal to 1 student. Mathematics and physics but not chemistry. Okay, mathematics and physics but not chemistry, which is equal to B. Mathematics, not chemistry. Okay, so not chemistry, mathematics and physics but not chemistry, so that is equal to B. Okay, mathematics and physics but not chemistry, so this area. Okay, so which is equal to B. Okay, mathematics and physics, this much area for mathematics and physics. Okay, so here the magnitude of mathematics and physics is B. Okay, you should not consider here. Okay, this covering chemistry also. Okay, so we need to calculate only mathematics and physics, so which is equal to B. Okay, so next, so mathematics and physics not chemistry. Mathematics and physics not chemistry is equal to B, so 6 students. Okay, only one of the subjects. Okay, only one of the subjects means max only plus physics only plus chemistry only. Okay, so max only means A. Okay, Max only means A. Okay. Physics only means C. Chemistry only means G. Okay, you should not include these areas. Okay. So, Max only A, Physics only C, Chemistry only means G. Okay. So, now we need to calculate only one of the subjects. So A plus C plus G equal only one of the subjects means Max only plus Physics only plus Chemistry only. So A plus C plus G, so that is equal to 4 plus 2 plus 5 is equal to 11 students. Okay, so next we have to find at least one of the three subjects. So we have to add all the elements in the Venn diagram. Okay, at least one of the three subjects means all the elements, sum of all the elements in the Venn diagram. Okay, so A plus B plus C plus D plus E plus F plus G. Okay, so that is equal to 4 plus 6 plus 2 plus 2 plus 3 plus 1 plus 5. So that is equal to 23 students. Okay, so 23 students studying at least any one of the three subjects. Okay, so none of the subjects. Okay, so total students is 25. Total students is 25. Students studying at least one of the three subjects is 23. Okay, so 25 minus 23 is 2. Okay, so none of the subjects. Okay, is number of students for none of the subjects is 2 students. Okay.